Hello again. So you know you need to reference all of the information sources used in your work, right? But how exactly do you do this, and what format should these references take? Let's check out an example. Okay, let's assume you're writing an essay. You found a brilliant article that supports your arguments, and you want to include a summary of its findings in your own work. No problem, just go for it. Right, here's the important bit. You now need to reference that information to make it clear that this is not your own work and to show other people where you got it from. To do this, you first add a citation within your text. There are two principal ways of doing this. Author date, where you include the author's name followed by their date of publication, or numeric, where you include a simple number. Whichever it is, it will appear within or immediately after the referenced information. Now, you might want to quote a written source word for word, so the reader can see the original text that you're commenting on. To do this, you'll need to put speech marks around the quoted text. This is known as a direct quotation and tells the reader that the text is identical to its original source. When quoting short phrases, you should also incorporate them into your sentences like this. You can even put large quotations in their own indented paragraph if you want, but try to avoid quoting too much text at any one time. If you'd rather reword text from another source, you can also paraphrase it. This demonstrates your understanding of the text and allows you to make it more concise and focused. It doesn't matter if you think your version isn't as polished, what matters is that the reader can see how well you've understood and interpreted it. Similar rules also apply to copying and reusing someone else's raw data, including tables of results, graphs, diagrams, and figures. Simply include that data within your text and, you guessed it, add a citation. Next, you need to expand on your citations in a detailed list of references, or bibliography as it's sometimes known, at the end of your work. Each citation should have a full reference that includes the name of the information source, the name of its author or creator, and there's often more than one, the date it was published, and where exactly it can be found. Depending on the source, you might also need to include other information such as the volume number, publisher name, and place of publication. If it's an electronic resource, you'll need to include its URL and when you last accessed it. And, depending on your subject, you might even need to include relevant background literature that you've read but not explicitly cited. All of which leads us on to referencing styles. There are hundreds of them out there, and each has a slightly different set of rules about how citations and reference lists should appear in your text. Most Newcastle University students use the Harvard at Newcastle style, but there's also Vancouver, IEEE, or Scholar, and many, many more. Your lecturers will expect you to use one specific type, and all your citations and references should match that style accurately and consistently. Same punctuation, same capitalization, same everything. There you have it, referencing in a nutshell. Whenever you refer to another source of information, simply insert a citation in your text, and then expand on that citation in a footnote or full list of references at the end of your work. Simple.